Hello, my name is Nathan.
And my name is Claire.
And welcome back to liveformusic.tv. We have the lovely Kylie Auldist coming in the show tonight. Okay, the girl had the number one track worldwide called This Girl last year. It was an anthem and it still is. So it's going to be great to sit on the couch with her and have a lovely chat to get to know her. What else are we going to be covering tonight, Claire?
So I'm going to be covering a music video by TK Maidza. And as always, I'll be doing the music news.
Stay tuned, guys. It's going to be an awesome show. See you soon.
Jimmy Barnes has revealed his most recent addition to the list of merchandise on his website. You can now be wailed awake by his old school style alarm clock, which is available in both blue and black and features the artist's classic blood-curdling cry. If you're looking for the perfect funny Christmas gift or a gift for someone you don't particularly like, this is the one. Angus and Julia Stone fans will be psyched to hear that the siblings have expanded their 2018 tour to include not just capital cities, but rural Queensland, Northern Territory, New South Wales, Victoria and Fremantle. Also joining them will be recent unearthed feature artist Angie McMahon. So make sure you catch them all in April and May next year. Carter Jala, Kira Dara have announced their headline show for 2018. The group were nominated for the Double J Artist of the Year and have released the dates for their tours in Melbourne and Sydney. They'll also be performing at Yuban, Mofo at Mona and Perth Festival. Make sure you check out their latest single, Womala, which means girl song. John Lennon's Diaries and Glasses, which were stolen from widow Yoko Ono back in 2006, have been found by police in Berlin. The items were suspected to have been stolen by Yoko Ono's driver and then taken to Turkey before being sold on and discovered in the boot of a car which was being searched. The last diary entry included installments from the very morning before Lennon was tragically shot in front of his New York apartment in 1980. TK Maidza is an amazing young artist. At 21, she has an impressive array of songs and performances under her belt. She released her first song, Brontosaurus, when she was only 17. After studying architecture and deciding to become a full-time musician instead, she released an EP called Switch Tape. Since then, she's performed all over the world, including Berlin, Los Angeles, and Paris, to name a few. Check out this hit called Carry On featuring Killer Mike. It's hard to sit still listening to this dance beat. The video is shot from dramatic angles with dramatic lighting and some awesome dance moves. The fashion in the video is fantastic, with an all-purple glitter suit in some scenes and seriously awesome blue glitter lipstick in others. She has a great voice and is an all-round talented dancer and performer. And that's music news for this week. Guys, I'd love to welcome the lovely Kylie Auldist.
Hi, Nathan.
So lovely to have you into the show.
Thank you for having me.
And what was that song, guys? This Girl. Okay, so you made the original back in 2009, 2008.
Yes, I sang on the original, yes, with Cookin on Three Burners.
For those who don't know, it ended up getting redone by Kungs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it was, everyone would know it called This Girl still. Featured number one around the world.
Mm.
How many countries? 20-odd countries.
Amazing, yeah. Well, he was, Kungs is a young French boy who's actually an protege of David Guetta.
Wow.
So, you know, you're obviously going to get some attention when you're playing in those sort of circles.
Yeah, definitely.
But, yeah, it's amazing. It's done amazingly and it's gone to number one in so many countries. And, I mean, I've been lucky enough to go and even just sing it myself in Scotland, England and Wales and to all these crazy kids.
Such an iconic voice
it.
You have.
Thanks.
I've got my own story about it. I was overseas last year on a sail Croatia and it was just our anthem. It came out last year, 2016, and we couldn't get enough of it.
It's amazing.
So Cookin' on Three Burners isn't the only band you work with now, and you still do, the Bamboos.
Yes, well, see, the common denominator there is Lance Ferguson, because
yeah.
He's the clever writer, and
I sing with him in the Bamboos, and we just did Queenscliff Music Festival, and we're just about to start on a new, we've written a new album, and we're about to perform it to the world.
Oh, wow.
So, coming up soon.
Okay, yes. And awesome. When are you planning on releasing that?
Well, it usually will come out in the start of the year. Okay. And so then we'll just go off and flog it.
Awesome. Of course.
Yeah, which will be exciting because there's some great songs on there. I mean, you know, we've all been doing it for long enough. We know how to write some songs, and hopefully we've got enough energy to sell them.
So good. And you've got a new song coming.
Body.
Body. Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. So how long ago did you start writing that song?
Oh, well, when we were on tour for my Family Tree album, we were in an Airbnb in Perth, and the boys said, like, let's just get out our instruments and write some music. And I was like, I might just get some food. And then I'm like, no. It was very organic. And I love 80s music. I mean, that was my thing. So, it's all synthesizers and computers. And when they started, it just came to me, and I just wrote the lyrics, and it became this song that I really love.
You grew up in Broken Hill, and then you stayed in New South Wales for quite some time, and then you moved to Melbourne when you were 22?
Yeah.
22, and that was for you to really give singing your best shot.
Yeah, I moved into a house right next door to the Evelyn Hotel, and I was always late for my gigs there.
And you were next door.
Yes. But I thought it was just so important. It was like Fitzroy was the place to be for music.
You went to the UK with the Bamboos.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then you got signed to True Thoughts.
Yeah, yes, I was very lucky. I was a bit shocked because I came out on stage with a pint. And they're like, what is she doing? I'm like, well, it's got to be, it's an hour and a half set.
The crowd as a gal, like, she's just
come on, man. They just hadn't met many Australian singers, I think.
Exactly.
It is thirsty
work. Quite used to it. No, that's awesome. And so you're doing Rockabye Baby coming up.
Yes.
The family festival.
It's a great gig, actually. It's put on by PBS Radio. And it's for people that have babies, but they don't want to stop being people. And they can take their kids to see an actual band that's not dumbed down for kids. You know, they don't do like Wiggles songs, and they don't have to wear a skivvy. It's just like it's awesome. Music. And babies love it. It's so cool. And the kids, you see them all dancing,
how
enjoying themselves.
That?
I've done it once before, but like PBS has been doing it for years and years.
Yeah,
I mean, it's pretty hard to get a gig. Everybody does it.
Fed Square for New Year's, guys, if you're around.
I know, right?
That would be unreal.
There'll be fireworks and all that sort of stuff.
How many songs do you plan on performing?
Well, we're doing a whole set, and we're doing the countdown one. So so I'm doing probably an hour's worth of music. Like, there'll be music going all night, you know, and I'm going to sing Auld Lang Syne by myself. So that's going to be interesting.
And so just right near the amphitheatre kind of thing.
Yeah, right in Fed Square.
Yeah.
Mm, so I'm interested to see how that'll go because I'm always a little bit wary of crowds and the middle of the city on New Year's Eve is not my thing really, but you know, I'll be on the stage, so it'll be okay.
Exactly.
I'm hoping.
So you've got your three albums with True Thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
And then your latest one, Family Tree, that wasn't with True Thoughts.
That's with Freestyle.
Freestyle,
yeah, okay. It's in London.
Okay. And how is it working with them?
Oh, they're great. Well, they were the original label for Cookin on Three Burners. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they're good people, and I put out Body, and it was just at the last minute, and so we told them about it, and they go, well, why don't we just put it on Craig, Craig Charles's, you know, album that he just put out. I love Craig Charles, so that's really handy. So that goes out across England, and you know, isn't it interesting that we write a little song in a little lounge room in Perth, and next minute,
it's like
it's on the radio in England.
Crazy.
I'm pretty happy about it.
You gotta be. So you gotta be so proud of yourself for the things you've achieved. Not many people can say it.
Well, the world is small now, you know, so we can be here and put something on the computer and it goes to somebody on the other side of the world like that. You know, we can be friends. I've written songs with people that I've never met on the other side of the world. It was funny, actually, because Aldo Vannucci, I think I've told people this, that he sent me some flowers and I got home and my husband was like, who's this from? And, you know, tell your boyfriend, ease up. I'm like, well, actually, I've never met him.
Oh, how good's that?
But I like him because the flowers are very nice.
Yeah. Anyone got some flowers for lovely Kylie Auldist?
Flowers don't go astray, people.
All right. Well, we might have to organise and wrap it up. Thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you so much.
How good was it having you on the show, guys? Such a talent. And I'm proud of myself for really interviewing you.
Oh, lovely to meet you.
So
lucky.
Thank you.
Thanks for getting my name right.
Yeah, of course. All right. See you later, guys.
Oh, thank you.
I'm
How sensational was that track?
That was sensational.
Song is called Sensational by Kylie Auldist. It was great having you on the show, wasn't it, Claire?
Yeah, it was. It was an excellent interview.
Yeah, it's good getting to know the girl. Make sure you guys, you give us a follow and a like on Facebook and Instagram.
Yep.
And we'll see you back again next week. Thanks for watching.